And here we go again. I am back with the dogs. We almost got delayed a bit because there was a delivery guy in the elevator that was a bit scared of my little chili dog, and he wouldn't leave the elevator, even though we gave him all the hallway. And then he would not leave the elevator, and Chili got impatient and barked at him, and this did not help the situation. But finally, we found a solution, and everything is good. But it took me some more minutes. So, the Antelope Valley in South California. Let's just look at the route introduction video, or, well, service can't hardly can tell us. We're doing this at Los Angeles station, and it will take us 10 minutes, I guess. So I'm happy that CD Radar likes the LNER train. The London and North Eastern Railway train. Yeah. It's a nice screenshot of Cajon Pass, isn't it? Louis Levy did a good job on this. So, Chili, what is it? Antelope Valley Line route introduction.
Welcome to LA Union Station, located in Los Angeles, California. Approved in 1926 and opened in 1939, LA Union Station was designed to consolidate rail services from Union Pacific, Santa Fe, and Southern Pacific into one station owned by the city. There's a missing route map over there. Fix that while you're here.
They always want us to do some collectibles. Can you hear the locomotive sound? That is impressive.
There are many more route tasks to discover. Make sure to apply the route maps, put up the anniversary banners, hang up the hats, and visit the hot dog stands.
So you're calling dibs on the
Clark
hot
Smith,
dogs?
your ship supervisor, would like to speak with you.
Clark Smith. All right. You're the supervisor. Clark. Hey, buddy. Can you do me a solid and hitch a ride out to Santa Clarita? I've got a train up there, but no free engineers. I've got Tim coming in to cover the shift, but he's an hour out at least in this traffic. If you head there now, then we can avoid more delays. Sure thing. Yes. AJ called dibs on the food trucks. Well, that's some spacey walkway. Well, this droning sound of this locomotive is really impressive. I have to repeat that. Oh, there are so many seats available, I can hardly choose. I always like to sit on the top floor. Maybe in this one. Okay, the seat. The game did not like this seat. And I take a seat in one of those cars here. Doesn't like one in the upper compartment, I guess. 5 yards, 3 yards. Now we're talking. And now I'm sitting at one seat with the blind down, or whatever.
The Antelope Valley Line runs for over 70 miles from the bustling heart of LA to Lancaster, the western tip of the Mojave Desert.
The Mojave Desert.
The railroad along the Santa Clara River originally opened in 1876 and was operated by Southern Pacific as a connection to the national rail network. In 1979, due to falling demand, this line ceased operation. In 1990, the Los Angeles County Transportation Commission purchased the right-of-way from Southern Pacific. Passenger services as far as Santa Clarita began operation in 1992. When the Northridge earthquake hit in 1994, plans to extend the line north to Antelope Valley were expedited by over 10 years to aid relief efforts. U.S. Navy Seabees and a legion of workers from the L.A. County Public Works Department constructed stations in just a few days, rather than the 3 to 6 months they usually take. Passenger services started on this extension less than a week after the earthquake. Today, this important commuter line carries over 5,700 people in and out of LA each day. Run to the hills and experience the hefty power of modern American diesel. Tackle the tough terrain of Californian canyons with the Antelope Valley Line, between the sprawling Los Angeles cityscape and the desert bushes of Lancaster, in almighty Metrolink traction. West Coast rails are yours to explore in Train Sim World, Antelope Valley Line.
Flip. All right, that was the route introduction. It looks nice. I like it. What we do, I think, is do the locomotive introduction. It'll be interesting to see if there is an introduction for driving it from the cab car as well. To the trains, choose the route, Antelope Valley. But I wanted to do the rail journeys. That's always getting to me. California Dreaming. Sprinted LA introduction of the F-125. Yeah, this is what I was looking for. Confer. Lancaster. There's no introduction for the possible mission take. Well, let's get the introduction running and see what they want us to do. AJ, is all good?
In this training module, you will be learning to operate this EMD F125 Spirit diesel locomotive. During this brief introduction, you will be taken through the critical driving controls and performing passenger operations. When you're ready to begin, climb aboard.
Oh, I managed to get on the train without hitting the
Sit
marker.
Sit in the engineer's seat.
That looks a bit like a submarine.
You'll now go through the steps needed to take over this locomotive. You will need to set the generator field switch. This needs to be enabled for the locomotive to generate power.
All right, we know those kind of switches.
This locomotive requires switch the front headlights on. Regardless of the time of day or weather, all locomotives must have their headlights on.
But we should do them to dim because we're in a station, probably.
You'll need to set the brakes to the correct mode to allow them to be controlled by this cab.
Ah. What can we have? Trail, test, freight, and passenger.
We can now begin loading.
Let's hope that the guard panel works. So, is there any way we can turn on number board lights, on step lights, or front marker lights? Off, on, rear marker lights. Now we don't.
It is time to depart. Close the passenger doors.
Car door override. Horn back up. Door light. Multiple units. In an emergency fuel cutoff reset, that is emergency cutoff run layover. What is that for? Set the 480 power source switch to external 480 front and rear position when connecting wayside power to the front ATP receptacles for operation in layover mode. Interesting. Gotta find out what that means. Head and power distribution both. Those indicator lights. Head and power on. Local head and power front and rear. Alright, we are not in layover mode then. So where is the safety system switch? Do we have one at least? Engineer's cab heater, windscreen wipers, auxiliary pulse lights, conductor signals, attendant call, horn sequencer, and stop button for both fuel pump and engine run. We know this one. Cab light center, emergency light, reset the. But does the screen do anything? We'll see if the length counter actually counts anything. Well, this thing here being empty does not promise too much. Alerter cut in, PTC circuit breaker on, ATS circuit breaker off. So we actually have a PTC circuit breaker. Did I miss a fuse box? Aha, here we are. Circuit breakers for a lot of things. The air dryer. APC circuit breaker, the auxiliary pin. There is the ATC automatic train stop. And here is the PTC circuit breaker. We'll find out if that does anything. There are a lot of circuit breakers. Can be played about. Battery on, that is good. All good, nice to hear. So, the PTC would actually run on this screen here, the IETMS system built by Wabtec. And It would actually display something that looks not unlike this thingy here, showing you in a form like this what the track gradient is, the signaling status, speed limits, and gives you the next target, like a speed reduction or a signal, tells you the maximum authorized speed and your actual speed, and the details of your movement authority, but unfortunately it is not working yet. So it will be interesting to find out what the PTAC fuse that is in this large circuit breaker board here actually does if it is not on. And from what we have seen, there is a PTC and ATS automatic train stop that can be switched on. Now I switched off the air brake, not the air brake, circuit breaker. No, I don't want to do that. The PTC, and where was the alerter, or what was it called? Vigilance. Here's the alerter cutout. There are our safety systems. Let's see what they actually do. And now the doors, we are supposed to close them using the forward door close, forward door open, local door open, rearward, conductor. Ah, that is nice. It's the first. Does it do anything? Not really. Well,
the reverser determines the direction of travel. The master controller controls both the throttle and dynamic brakes. Dynamic brakes use the locomotive's electric traction motors to generate resistance to reduce the wear of the brake pads. Apply a small amount of throttle.
Really? We're supposed to run with handle off brakes? That is a bit weird. Or do we want to have froth before we release the train brakes? Well, this is why I applied the independent brake.
The automatic brakes are controlled with their own handle, but will blend the dynamic brakes in the air brakes. The air brakes will apply braking force to every car in this formation. Now, release the brakes.
Maybe you don't do this on a freight train, on a passenger train, but I'm so used to holding the train with the independent brake. What speed are we here? 200. Well, maybe we won't go to 200. 49 miles. Length counter does not work.
Keeping to speed limits is important. If you begin overspeeding, slow the train using the master controller's dynamic brake range. The EMD F125 is a passenger locomotive manufactured by Electromotive Diesel for the North American market.
All right.
It's powered by a Caterpillar C127 20V20 diesel engine, rated at 4,700 horsepower, and is capable of speeds up to 125 miles per hour. When it launched in 2017, it was the first new passenger locomotive in North America in 15 years. To date, 40 have been produced, all of which were supplied to Metrolink. The F125 features a modern, streamlined body designed by Vaslo España.
Vaslo, like the G6. And then we have a Caterpillar engine. It's not so surprising since EMD, if I'm not mixing things up again, belongs to Progress Rail, which in turn belongs to Caterpillar. So they are using their own company mother's engines on this locomotive. So let's see how this thing slows down for a stop. Funny on this round courses is that the distance to target never changes. It's always around 1.4. kilometers. You're never getting there.
You are approaching the station. Begin applying a small amount of braking force using the automatic brake to bring the train to a gentle stop.
So we're not getting any dynamics blended in because I can't see any braking effort. Now it maybe starts. But not really over enthusiastically the braking.
Nice job. The train has safely come to a stop. You can now begin loading. Good work. That concludes all the basics of operating this train.
All right. So here we got the correct cap set up, not applicable. And we got our purple heart. Interesting. So Let's see if we can actually run a service with this train through the along the line. Always falling for it. Well, let's just use this one and see what happens. They said in the patch note that it is not possible to get the purple heart platinum metal. On those services because of the way the safety system works. Well, we'll get to see. On the right, there are the doors. So, generator field. Light is already on, but on bright. In the station, brakes are in test mode, trail, freight, passenger, equalizing reservoir is set, let's put that to release them. Number lights I want, and I want my safety systems. Sometimes I will switch something off that does severe harm to the locomotive setup. Alerter. Oh. There was not that much time to prepare the train. The limit here. What? 12? That is an interesting limit. And obviously we are speeding already. And do we have a red here? Sure. Now we probably should not have started this service. Gotta leave the trains or let the trains leave the station at this point. Ah, this is our alert reset button. Actually, two trains are leaving in front of us. Well, it actually says on the hard rate. The other trains are still visible there. People with luggage. And now we can go, and if I remember that correctly, this should be a diverging approach. But with the dwarf signals, I'm never sure entirely. We have an accelerometer here. Let's see how reliable this thing works. We have a reading of 1 PSI in the brake cylinders. Like, that's not... I know it went away. So, since this was a diverging approach, it's... We're supposed to be prepared to stop at the next signal, but we are diverging here. That was the alerter, nice. But no, we have a green clear. Still in the level, the limit of 12 for the station area, most probably. But at least green signals. Oh, the traction indicator jumps around in a weird way. Getting rain. First time we're seeing rain. The unmodded rain. Typically I'm using the rain mod as the one single mod that I'm using in my typical setup. But obviously this is the original rain and the original new pattern of raindrops on the windscreen. Ah, speed limit increased. Speed limit to 30, according to this board. Let's see if this agrees with what the HUD says as soon as the train has passed the speed sign. Yes. It'll be interesting to see if there are whistle boards for this one. We did not get any whistle boards for this level crossing, at least I did not see one. Then I have to switch off the stuff that got turned on by the introduction and the local introduction. So that it's not too easy. No, I did not see what the sign said. Further increase in speed limit. At least the signals are clear. Well, let's see if the horn sequencer works actually. Well, probably not. Or maybe I'm just not doing it right. But the horn itself works, doesn't it? And it turns on the bell. Increase to 50. Here goes the sequencer. All of a sudden. Does it have a built-in delay for certain speeds? So AJ, if you're listening, what do you think? Do we need the rain mod again for Trains in World 4, or is that good enough? You're enjoying the rain as it is, then maybe we just leave it then. So it's up for us, I guess it is. Next signal will probably be an approach one. And it is quite close, the approach one. So we slow down to 30, no, I think 40 is okay for us as a passenger train. But on Sunday we will have a proper signaling stream about the signaling system here. Just make sure that we can actually stop at the next signal, if it will be as close as the last one was. So if only we knew where the next signal is located. Okay, signal is no longer the red. It is an advanced approach again, so we can speed up a little to 50 as a passenger train, if I'm not mistaken. Speed limit is increasing, but it does not help because we have to keep below the 50 because of the signal. And we should already be at Glendale. And the barber pole. Ah, no. We gotten close enough. Let's see how the train reacts to slowing down. Does not really want to slow down this train. So the So on what side are we supposed to open the doors, right? Seems okay. Urban town, and we have an open speed limit of 79 miles. What are the signals like? Advance approach again. So 50. Have you seen any whistleboards, AJ, so far? Because I think I have not. Was that a whistle board? Didn't really see. Shape wise, it could have been okay. Well, there was at least a level crossing, so maybe it was one. Advance approach, so we can keep to 50. Yeah, that is a whistle board. They have those X style whistle boards, I think, just like on the peninsula corridor with a baby bullet. As it seems. No, I missed the whistle board again. There was a whistle board with an additional sign that it applies to more than one level crossing. But I did not read the number. So we should get closer to Burbank downtown. At least we should already be there. But if we stick to the speed prescribed by the signals, how are we supposed to make this in time? Now an approach telling us to slow down to 30. No, as a passenger train 40, I guess. And still not within the barber pole activation range. Are those signals up ahead? Or just raindrops? Because we're running under approach, meaning we have to stop at the next signal to avoid a span. Well, at least the barber pole activated. Well, with all the stutter, it is not so easy to get a feeling for the brake. So, I think the timeliness is factored into this bonus figure here, together with the accuracy of the stop. We're already 2 minutes behind schedule. Burbank Airport North, track 1. Ah, that reminds me that we're running with dimmed lights all the time. Maybe we should change that. What? Why is the fuel pump sitting on the same keyboard short as the light switch? I have to look into that. Oh. There is a speed limit, obviously, because we went across the switch, but now it increased to 50 again. Obviously, I do not want to cut out my fuel pump. Okay. The Unreal Engine is learning this route and the shaders, and we have stutters without end. Now we've got clear signals, but a track limit of 50. Now increase 60. 180. We can go with 60 across the switch, but there is a station up ahead. So much for that. It'll be interesting how driving this cab car is. Almost looks like a locomotive itself. And funny enough, we are back on the timetable with this harsh stop here. If we ever get punished for braking too harshly, yay, Train Sim World 4 CD radar is back. But we are doing American stuff. Oh, there is one of your hot dog stands, AJ. Well, if this guy has so much fun in the rain, I'm not sure. So, Sun Valley, track 1, there is, you're another break. In case you're wondering why I'm so late with my 14L sequence, it's because I still have to find out if I can rely on whistle boards and where the crossings are. Just feeling my way through this route for the very first time. And we have a limit of 79. Throughout the whole track. This time I saw the whistle board. And I missed the station again. And this time there is no help. We will miss this station utterly. Good. That was an objective failure. But now the game, as we can see, we can skip objectives. If we fail to stop at the station, we can just go on. Don't need to reverse and stuff, just go on. See, the radar asks, what is this bizarre train? This is the Metrolink EMD F125. With the bi-level cars. So I need to be more careful with the stations now. Not to run a Sulmar San Fernando too. Well, those stutters are really getting at me. At least maybe we are out of the rain now. Come on! DD Radar, I will read and answer your question as soon as I got through this stuttering here. This is... really a bit hard. If your game takes input only every 3/10 of a second. CD Radar asks if I know if you... uninstall Train Sim World 2 and 3 from the PC. Will the DLC still be playable on Train Sim World 4? Yes, I'm quite sure they will be. There's a 75 and later then a 60 or something. But excuse me, it's a bit harsh, the stuttering here. Bedtime for you, have a great rest of your stream. Alright. Good game for people, yes. Thank you. Well, with all this stuttering, you never know whether the game takes your keyboard input or not. All the while we are approaching, we're getting an approach signal. Didn't even see the advance approach. Hallelujah. So now I should need to know where the next set of signals is. You're also looking forward to test Vectron on the LZB. Yeah, that's true. Well, I actually could do the test of Vectron on the LZB. At least on Munich, I guess. So we are approaching the station. We are ahead of time now. Would be good to know if there is a signal in front of the station. This is really the worst in lag that I have ever seen in this game. So I hope the shaders are now baked well after this run. Okay. Through thunder, lightning and rain and stutters and speeding and whatever, we made it to the station here at least. Now we are 1:30 ahead of time. Is it really? It is not San Fernando, is it? San Tornado, maybe. There are actually stop markers. Maybe I should try aiming for those. 60, 45 later. Jesus. Now the 45 is announced, and they have the speedball variety, if I remember correctly. Where they announce a reduction in speed limit, like half a mile in advance, and then half a mile later it starts without a new sign. To announce it even more. Those are just the signs from the back. All this stuttering, you do not really get a feeling for how your train is picking up speed or slowing down. We're again in a 45, or at least sooner running into one, I guess. Yeah, and then even slower. 35, 30, I guess, until we are uphill. Now it's 45 on. Now we can hear the wipers. No. We still have some rain on the windscreen. So are we getting a sign for the reduction to 35? I guess we do. I guess here it is. But what did it say? I think it's a 40. But this looks more like 35. Holy moly. Advanced approach. Now we're getting into a sincere gradient of 2.2. So it shouldn't be too difficult to slow down this train. And it's 35. But the loco does not have any problems pulling us uphill here. Next reduction will be 30. That looks like an approach diverging. Let's see where we are going to diverge to. That's a bit like running up Cajon Pass with the F7, slowing down. To 5 miles. So we're running downhill then. After the tunnel we're running downhill, yes. But we are still running uphill. So this tunnel here is obviously a bottleneck for the whole line. can't be so much to render and shade in the tunnel, can there? Diverging approach. And a lot of rain. What will the speed limit do? Go to 40? Now that we're running downhill. That's already switched. But approaching a red signal, so maybe want to take it easy downhill here. So engine run, I did not want to turn that off. So where is my next signal? At least we're getting close to Newhall. So probably no more signal before we get into the station. Okay, downhill the train doesn't want to stop at all. $479, not so bad. And the signal is red in front of us. There is our red signal that we have been warned about. Closing the doors. We can't go yet because the signal is still red. Santa Clara, now it gave us a clear. For some reason the automatic brake was still on a bit. Just saw that the brake pipe was not back at 110. You know, we're running downhill. 1.2%. But the speed limit increased to 70. But we'll be back to 50 later. So we will not go to 70 now, probably. Already have been a sign. And later it slows down even more.
Thank you.
But will it slow down to 40, I guess. But then we're going uphill again. So we can have the train coast here, I guess. What, a limit of 39? Interesting. Aha, getting closer to the station. What did it say, 30? It said 30. Almost started to miss the lags. Here is the stop marker we are. What are we, by the way? 5 cars? We count the locomotive in. 486. Not the worst one ever. But it's raining for the whole trip. Via Princesa, track 1. Isn't that nice? What I like is that the screen is not flickering anymore. Remember that from... That was a 30 reduction. Advance approach again, limit up to 70. So I'm accelerating to 50. Thank you. Incoming limit 2. Didn't read it. 45. 55 for passengers. Approach. I guess I mistook something for a whistle board. Most probably again a signal behind the station. I just wonder why they are keeping the signals at red behind the station. That always slows us down. Because you have to adhere to what the signals tell us. So is that the station where we are supposed to stop? That is a long station. So this is a battle. Vista Canyon. And then we're done with this first part. Alright. I just hope that this stuttering will be better on the second run. It starts immediately now. First we're back to 79 and then to 15, or did someone not throw the switch? In what bottleneck are we running in now? Diverging approach. Mm-hmm. Now we are on the 25 track, I am quite sure. Still running uphill. Well, this train is not held back a lot by uphill gradient. And this will stay at 25. So this train is not really slowed down a lot by gradient, but it is accelerated by gradient easily. So, closing in on our final destination and stop. In the Vista Canyon. So those red thingies are not signals, good to know. Stop markers are turned around so that the passengers can see them, but not the engineer. All right. So that was our first run along the Antelope Valley. Obviously not the whole tour, but the first part of it. And we missed one station, actually. What is? Did not happen to me a lot before. And still we get the platinum medal, even though it was communicated that you cannot achieve the platinum medal on the Antelope Valley. Weird. Speeding, we lost a bit on time bonus, accuracy bonus, correct cap setup, we got something, safety system used, no, interesting, well, I think that was enough for today. We have seen the Vorarlberg Route, we have seen the Vectron, we have seen the Antelope Valley, and I really hope that these stutters and freezes will be better next time when we run this route. It looks really promising. The way it was really a strain. Nevertheless, we got a purple heart on the Antelope Valley, even though it was communicated that you cannot get platinum on those runs in the Antelope Valley line. Don't even know what was it. It's one of those services here. Well, thank you for staying with me as long as you stayed with me. Thank you, CD Radar. Thank you, AJ, for moderating this stuff. And tomorrow we will try to do something less on the fly and talk about the Austrian signaling. Thank you very much and have a good night.